What's going on, my good people? Mike Hidalgo here. Thank you for joining us on another FCP Euro DIY. Today we're going to be working on a 2018 BMW M4 F82. Today on the M4 behind me, we're going to be covering how to do an oil change. This is a simple yet super important DIY that anyone at home can tackle in the garage or in the driveway or on the lift if you have one. This DIY will be applicable to all models with the S55. In front of us, we have one of our many kits available on fcpo.com. We have a Liqui Moly 5W40 kit, which includes the 7 liters of oil, the man filter, as well as the gaskets and crush washers needed. The only thing that we have added to this kit, which is also linked below, is a rain magnetic drain plug. We recommend you do this service every 5,000 miles, even though the dealer and the manufacturers can say that the oil can be extended up to twice that. With these direct injection engines, the amount of buildup that can be deposited into the oil over time on long intervals can cause damage inside of the engine over time. So 5,000 miles is a safe interval, and with the lifetime replacement guarantee, it makes that a little bit easier. But before we get into this DIY, let's take a look at some of the tools we're gonna need for this job. For this DIY, you're gonna need a torque wrench. We have a 3/8 drive torque wrench, as well as a 3/8 drive ratchet, a 17 millimeter socket, a small pick, a small flathead screwdriver will work as well. We have an oil filter wrench cap, as well as a CTA European no spill funnel. And not pictured here, but needed, is going to be a catch pan for your oil. Both the funnel and the wrench will be linked in the description below. And with that, let's go ahead and get started on this DIY. All right, my good people, first things first, under the hood of the F82, we're going to start by breaking the vacuum seal by removing our oil fill cap. That's going to allow us to drain everything a little bit easier. And since we're working indoors, we can go ahead and set this to the side. We're not worried about anything falling in here, but if you're outdoors, leave the cap on just at an angle. That'll still allow everything to breathe. While we're up here, we're also gonna work on breaking the seal at our oil filter, letting it drain for a sec in our hands, and then pulling it out. That way that can drain as well while the oil's draining. I recommend a couple shop towels around the housing, just in case there's any spillage. And then you can use the shop towels to grab the filter on the way up so you don't drip all over your car. We're using our oil filter wrench and just a ratchet 3/8 drive for the cap. All right, we're gonna set this to the side and let it drain for now. Before we reinstall our new filter, we're gonna let everything drain out. We'll show you how to replace the seals on the oil filter cap. But in the meantime, let's hop underneath and drain some oil. Underneath the M4, my good people, our drain plug is located in the middle of the steel reinforcement plate. Your vehicle may have a plastic cover here, which in case you have a small tab to remove. If not, you'll see your 17 millimeter drain plug easily accessible, point straight down. So we're gonna use a 17 on our socket wrench. And it goes without saying, if the engine's a bit warm, the oil will flow out a bit easier versus doing this on a cold motor. Also with that, be mindful that if the oil is hot, you don't want it running on your hands and burning your fingers. So just be careful when doing an oil change on a warm engine. I'm gonna break that free. And then I always like to keep a bit of constant pressure up on the drain plug while I'm turning it out. That way, once I feel that it's basically finished unthreading itself, we can try to pull away quickly without taking a bath in oil. Make sure your old crush washer comes down as well. In this case, it did. We have a new one that comes with our oil filter, and we will be replacing the drain plug. However, these are reusable. After time, though, they do wear out. So if you've done this 100 times, excessive number there, doesn't hurt to replace it. It's only a couple dollars. But today we're gonna be upgrading to the Rhein magnetic drain plug. So we'll give that a few minutes to drain, and then we'll come back and button it back up. All right, my good people, at this point, we have come down to a slow, steady drip. Truthfully, we could be here all day should we let it be like this, but we gave it about 15 minutes. So this will be good to rock and roll. We'll give it a little wipe before we install the plug so we don't get oil all over ourselves. But we have our drain plug ready to go with a new crush washer. Always replace the crush washer. We're gonna set our torque wrench to 25 newton meters and torque down our drain plug. You don't want to over tighten it, as it is going into an aluminum pan and they can be very easy to strip. All right, 25. There we go. Not a whole lot, just enough to crush down our crush washer. Should you still have a bunch of oil around here, hit it with some brake clean, give it a good wipe. Now let's head back up top, put our new filter in and some fresh liquid moly. Now we're gonna go ahead and get our oil filter housing cap ready to rock and roll. We have a couple seals to remove. This is where a small pick or a small screwdriver will come in handy. We have the main sealing seal, which we're gonna remove. There's a ridge dedicated to that seal, so make sure you don't have the seal past it or before it on the threaded portion still. I don't know where that went. You wanna make sure that the seal is lubed up with a bit of oil. You can use some fresh oil, or if there's still some on your threads, use that just to help it seal once we go to put it back in. We also have to replace the screen O-ring. Now we can take our new man filter, pop that on, and now we can thread it back in. You can pretty much snug this all the way down by hand without the tool, but we are going to go ahead and torque it down to the specified 25 newton meters, which we can see on the cap. So we'll take our torque wrench, which is still set to 25. We'll put our oil filter wrench tool on top, feed that on. So you can see we were pretty much there. We got maybe an eighth of a turn. Now with that, we're going to take our funnel, get this locked into place, and we're going to feed the S55 6.5 liters of liquid moly. That's the capacity for this engine. We'll start with the 5-liter jug first. And don't forget, you also have an interval sticker, which you can pull off and place on the windshield so you know next time you need to change the oil. I like to start with the 5-liter jug first, then we'll do one of the small 1 liters, and then we'll do half of the 7th liter. Now we're gonna do half a liter of the last 1 liter container, and that'll give us our 6.5 capacity. Now with that, we'll let the funnel drip down just a little bit, and then we'll put our cap back on. We're gonna hop inside and just reset our service interval. All right, my good people, inside of the M4, we're gonna reset the oil service. Inside the car, press the start-stop engine button once without your foot on the brake pedal. We're gonna allow the service to message and anything else that may pop up to clear. So now we're gonna hold down our odometer reset button until a service reset possible message comes up. Then from there, we can click the odometer button to shuffle through the options. This is brake fluid, we have engine oil, vehicle check, rear brake pads, front brake pads, you get the idea. So we're gonna go to engine oil and hold the odometer reset button down. It'll say reset ? Hold it down again. And then we can let go. And with that, reset successful. And that is going to conclude this DIY for today, my good people. Overall, a really straightforward job on the S55. Super easy to do, and a great first DIY if you just got an F8X vehicle. If you like this DIY, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments on what we did today, or you want to see us do a specific DIY on this chassis, leave that in the comment section below. And if you like this video and you want to see more like them, please consider subscribing. We make new ones all the time. As always, thank you so much for watching. We'll catch you in the next one.